Hello friends, welcome back to Cost Accounting. So today I am going to teach a very important and simple concept, that is economic order quantity. So economic order quantity is a very simple concept and it is very easy to understand, and this is one of the most common topic for all undergraduate students like BCom, BBA, and even this concept is very useful for CA and CMA students, and for their intermediate and also for their foundation course this concept is very useful. So now let us see what is economic order quantity. So economic order quantity, it is the size of the order which minimizes the sum of ordering cost and carrying cost relating to raw materials. So economic order quantity is just, it is nothing but it is a size of the order, that size of the product that you order, correct. So it is very simple, it is as simple as that. It is just a size that you are going to place an order, correct. Say for example we say order 500 units, 600 units or 1000 units. So that is the quantity that the organization is going to place an order. The ordering cost and carrying cost. So this helps the organization to increase their efficiency and profitability, because if the ordering cost and the carrying cost reduces, it is going to make a huge impact on the purchase of raw materials. You are going to save some cost. So that's why it is a very important method. So ordering cost or economic order quantity is a method which is used to minimize the ordering cost and the carrying cost. So it is the most optimal method used by an organization to reduce the cost. And while purchasing the raw materials, so if you can take an example of any organizations, so while purchasing the raw materials or while placing an order, every organization is going to incur three types of cost. So what are those three types of cost? One is purchase cost, then ordering cost, then carrying cost. So these are the three main cost that every purchase is going to include. So before that, now let me tell you what is purchasing cost. So purchase cost is nothing but it is the cost of raw material, correct. So here, say for example, if any company wants to purchase 10,000 units, just imagine there is a company called A, and that company needs to purchase 10,000 units, and the 10,000 units cost is rupees 10 per unit. So for one unit they are going to pay 10 rupees, and for 10,000 units it will be 1 lakh rupees. So this is the purchasing cost. So this quantity we need to decide, this 10,000 units is the quantity, it should be an economical order quantity. This 10,000 should benefit the organization, this 10,000 should minimize the carrying cost, this 10,000 should minimize the carrying cost and inventory cost, correct. And next we have ordering cost. So what is ordering cost? See, in addition to this 1 lakh rupees, in addition to this purchasing cost, company will incur ordering cost also. So before placing an order, the company is going to incur delivery charges, inspection charges, examination charges, telephone charges. So like this, the company is going to incur some kind of expenditure, and that is also a part of your purchasing cost. If your quantity is more, if your purchasing cost is more, then your ordering cost will also increase. The higher the cost of material, higher will be the ordering cost. And carrying cost. So carrying cost is nothing but it is a cost of storage. It is a cost of storage of raw materials in the godown or in the warehouse. Correct. So after purchasing this 10,000 units by paying 1 lakh rupees, you need to store those materials in a warehouse. You need to store those material in a store or a godown or a warehouse. And for that warehouse, you need to pay rent. And for the stock, you must have an insurance policy for your stock, and you will have to pay tax on such items, correct. So that is called as your carrying cost. So carrying cost is the cost incurred to store the products in a godown, and all these are expenditures. So this ordering cost and carrying cost will increase, and we will increase because with the proportion of your purchasing cost. So more will be the purchasing cost, higher will be the ordering cost and carrying cost. If the purchasing cost is less. If you are purchasing a less quantity, then the ordering cost and carrying cost will also be less. So we have to be very careful when we are purchasing the raw materials. So before purchasing the raw materials, we will have to decide the quantity that we are going to purchase. So that is known as your economic order quantity. So economic order quantity is the size that we are going to place an order, correct? So that quantity is going to reduce the ordering cost as well as the carrying cost. So that is economic order quantity, and this is the most beneficial and optimal method to calculate to place an order. And here we have a formula to calculate economic order quantity or the size of the product, correct? So the formula is like this: EOQ is equals to square root of 2AB divided by CS. So this is as simple as that. So 2AB divided by CS, you just have to remember 2AB, square root of 2AB divided by CS. So here A represents annual consumption or annual demand, and B represents buying cost or cost per order. A is annual cost or annual demand, B is buying cost or cost of an order, and the C is nothing but cost per unit of material, and S is storage cost or carrying cost. So instead of writing C, S, you can also take this formula, 2AB divided by C. So it is very easy to remember also. And so because why I am using this S, because sometimes this carrying cost is calculated in terms of percentages. So if the carrying cost is not given directly, then we have to calculate that, we have to take the percentage of cost per unit. So because the carrying cost or inventory cost is sometimes calculated in the percentage basis, correct? So that's why I have taken C S. Okay, so now let us understand this simple concept with the simple example. Okay, so here is the first problem. So in this first problem, Prasad wants to know the economic order quantity of his organization. Okay, see, Mr. Prasad owns a men's clothing line, and Prasad needs to buy 12,000 shirts per year to fulfill the demand. He incurs setup cost of rupees 100 and holding cost rupees 16 per shirt, and calculate EOQ. So using this information, we need to calculate the economic order quantity of Mr. Prasad. Okay, so let's begin with the solution. Okay, so the formula to calculate EOQ is like this: EOQ is equals to square root of 2AB divided by C. Okay, so here A is, so what is annual demand? You have to see that annual demand. See, Prasad needs to buy 12,000 shirts per year. So this is the demand or annual consumption. So annual consumption is 12,000. Okay, now what is B? That is buying cost or cost of an order. See, the demand, he incurs setup cost of rupees 100 and holding cost of rupees 16. So the setup cost or the cost of buying is nothing, it is 100 rupees 100. And what is C here? See, holding cost or inventory cost is rupees 16. So these are the information given in the problem. Okay, so now I'm just plugging those numbers in the EOQ formula. Okay, so square root of 2A, annual demand 12,000, into B, buying cost or setup cost rupees 100, divided by C. C is nothing but the carrying cost or holding cost. So now square root of 2 into 12,000 into 100, so you are going to get 34,56,000 divided by 60. So now again, square root of 34,56,000 divided by 16. So you are going to get 2,16,000. So 2,16,000, square root of 2,16,000 is nothing but 464.75, or you can also write 465 units. I have just rounded off this units. So the economic quantity, economic order quantity of Mr. Prasad is 465 units. So this is the first problem of economic order quantity. And let me solve one more problem on the same economic order quantity, and this has one additional adjustment here. Okay, see the problem. Raju Limited required 1500 units of materials per month. So here Raju company required 1500 units per month. Okay, so remember, per month costing of rupees 27 per unit, cost per order is rupees 150, and inventory carrying cost is 20%. See here they have given inventory cost in the percentage. So I told, sometimes organization is going to calculate their carrying cost or holding cost in the percentage also. Okay, and find out EOQ and number of orders to be placed. See here, there is one extra information here that we need to calculate number of orders to be placed in a year. Okay, so now let us solve this problem. Okay, so your formula is square root of 2AB divided by C, or CS is your formula. So now let us see the items here. Okay, so annual demand. So what is the annual demand given in the problem? 1500 units per month is given. 1500 units per month. See, but our formula tells us to take annual consumption or annual demand. So it is very simple. You just convert this monthly materials into yearly. Okay, so I will just write 1500 into 12. So 1500 into 12, you are going to get 18,000. So here I will write 18,000. Annual consumption or annual demand is 18,000. So 1500 into 12. Okay, next, buying cost. So what is the buying cost here? See, cost per order is rupees 150. So cost per order is 150. And C is inventory carrying cost 20%, and cost of rupees 27 per unit. So here we need to calculate this carrying cost. So how do you calculate this carrying cost? Inventory carrying cost 20% is given. So 20% on what we have to take? 20% we have to take on the cost per unit. So the cost per unit is 27. So 27 is the cost per unit. So just calculate 20% on this. Okay, so I'll just write here 20% of 27. 20% of 27. So you are going to get 5.4 you are going to get. So this is how we need to calculate. We need to identify the important information. Okay, so now let me substitute. Okay, so 2AB divided by CS, square root of 2. A is annual consumption that we have already calculated, 18,000 into buying cost 150. Buying cost 150 divided by 5.4. Okay, next. So 2 into 18,000 into 150. So you are going to get 54,000 divided by 5.4. So 54,000 divided by 5.4. So 54,000 divided by 5.4. Okay, so square root of 54,000 divided by 5.4. So you will get square root of 1 lakh. Square root of 1 lakh you will get. Okay, so square root of 1 lakh is nothing but, if you do the square root, you will get 1000 units. So economic order quantity is 1000 units. So this is how we need to calculate EOQ. And in this problem, they have asked us to calculate number of orders to be placed in a year. So how many orders they are going to place, that we need to calculate. So to calculate number of orders, we have a simple formula to calculate the number of orders to be placed. Okay, so I just write number of orders to be placed is equals to, number of orders to be placed is equals to A is nothing but your annual consumption divided by EOQ. annual consumption divided by EOQ. If you do this, you will get number of orders to be placed. See, this number of orders to be placed is nothing but how many orders you are going to, how many times you are going to place an order in a year. So that is called as number of orders to be placed. So every time you are going to place 1000 units. So that may be 5 times you may order, 6 times, 10 times, 12 times, 20 times also you can order, you can place an order. But how many units you will order? 1000 units. So, like that, how many times you will order, that we need to calculate here, okay. See, annual demand or annual consumption is 18,000. So, 18,000 divided by EOQ we have already calculated 1000 units. So, 18,000 divided by 1000, you are going to get 1818. So, this is the number of orders to be placed. So, I will just write 18 times or 18 order. So, here the Raju Limited needs to place 18 times or 18 orders in a year. So, this is how we need to calculate the number of units to be placed. Okay. So, now let us solve one more problem on EOQ. See, the problem goes like this, calculate EOQ and number of orders to be placed in a year, and they have given some information here, okay. Quarterly consumption 2000 units is given, cost of placing rupees 50 is given, cost per unit rupees 40, and storage and carrying cost 8% of inventory is given. So, using this information we need to calculate economic order quantity as well as the number of units placed in a year, okay. So, let us solve this problem, okay. So, the formula to calculate this EOQ is, it is very simple, no? 2AB divided by C. So, ABC alphabets, you can, it is very easy to remember, okay. So, what is A here? See, quarterly consumption 2000 unit is given. So, A is nothing but annual consumption or annual demand. But here they have given quarterly consumption. So, we need to convert this quarter consumption into year. So, how do you convert? See, as we all know, there are 4 quarters in a year, isn't it? So, for one quarter, they are ordering 2000 units. So, for 4 quarters, so how much it will become? 2000 into 4. So, this will become 8000. So, annual consumption is 8000. Okay. Next, B. So, buying cost. So, how much they have given buying cost? They have given 50. So, 50 is the buying cost, rupees 50. And C. So, what is C here? 40 is given, but you cannot take this only 40 because it also involves storage cost also. So, just calculate this C using, using this 8%. Okay. So, C is 8% of rupees 40. So, C is 8% of 40, you will get 3.2. Okay. So, now let me substitute. Okay. So, square root of EOQ is equals to square root of 2. A is annual demand 8000 we have calculated, and B is rupees 50, it is given in the problem, and C is 3.2, that also we have calculated 3.2. So, now square root of 2 into 18000 into 50 divided by 3.2, you will get 8 lakh divided by 3.2. Now, again square root of 8000 divided by 3.2. So, you will get 2,50,000. So, 2,50,000 square root, you will get 500 units. So, this 500 units is your economic order quantity. So, very simple, easy to understand. Okay. So, now we should also calculate number of orders to be placed. Okay. And there is a simple formula here. So, calculation of number of orders to be placed. So, number of orders is equals to annual demand divided by EOQ as the formula to find out number of orders to be placed. So our annual demand is 8000. We have calculated. Okay, so 8000 divided by EOQ, that is also we have calculated 500 units. So 8000 divided by 500, you are going to get 16. So this 16 is the times or an order. 16 times or 16 orders. So in a year, company can order 16 times. So they can reorder 16 times to get their annual consumption. See, annual consumption is 8000 and their economic order quantity is 500, and in a year they can order 16 times. Okay, so this is how we need to calculate the economic order quantity and number of units produced. And it is very easy and very simple to understand, and this method is very common method for all commerce students, CA and ICW students. This is going to help for their foundation and intermediate course also. Okay, so this is economic order quantity, and thank you so much.